Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Steve Shabbat of Ohio.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman, and thank you very much, Ambassador, for being here today. I had the pleasure of meeting you in the Capitol building for the first time last week when you met with a number of members, and thank you for your time then, and thank you for your time now. And a whole lot of us have been very impressed with what we've seen and heard thus far since you've entered into your current position. So thank you for your leadership.
Thank you.
At this important time in our history. I'm going to repeat to some degree, first of all, what a number of other members have expressed as a big concern of theirs. It is mine as well, and that's the UN Human Rights Council. It seems that they spend an inordinate amount of time, it seems like most of their time, really, criticizing one of our most important allies, Israel. And as you know, you recently stated to the council, quote, it is essential that this council address its chronic anti-Israel bias if it is to have any credibility, unquote. And I certainly agree with you in that respect. And I'd perhaps even go further. I don't know if it's possible for them to gain credibility after the the waste of time that they've spent criticizing Israel. So I'd again welcome your input, anything you'd like to tell us on that issue.
Thank you. And I had referred to the Human Rights Council before. The reason I went to Geneva was very much to say it to them and not just send a statement from New York. And we just said for the United States to be involved in the Human Rights Council, they have to give us a reason to be. Because right now, we're going to be for human rights. It's either going to be inside or outside the council. What you saw was a lot of other countries are embarrassed by Agenda Item 7. They get that it discredits them, and they understand something needs to happen. What they have suggested is that it is Saudi Arabia, Egypt, and Pakistan that continue to use Agenda Item 7. We are now going to try and work with those three and see what we can do to get that to stop, because I think that's incredibly important. But also, I think we need to have competitive elections. No. You know, when you've got Cuba and Venezuela and Saudi Arabia and China and all these on the Human Rights Council, there's something very wrong. And what it has become over the years is a place that bad actors go to sit to keep the sunlight from shining on them. Yep. It very much embarrasses these countries when human rights is brought up. And it's very much the reason they don't want me to bring it up in the Security Council, but I will continue to do that. So that's why we have a decision to make. And we will see if they make any proactive changes to the Human Rights Council, and then we'll decide whether the U.S. is better to be in it or off of it. But that's a dilemma that we're still going through.
Thank you. I agree with you completely. Let me turn now to Korea. We have 28,000 approximately U.S. troops there. And as we all know, they had elections recently, and they have a new president who tends to be more on the left than the previous government was. And one of his first acts was to suspend deployment of the THAAD missile defense, which I think was a big mistake. But they have put, I think, our troops at risk. And President Trump said as much recently when he said he didn't feel that our troops were safe there. And it would seem to me that we ought to give South Korea a choice. They have the choice of having the most sophisticated missile defense system, the THAAD system, to defend them and to defend our troops. So they get the missile system and our troops, or they have no missile defense and no U.S. troops. I think it ought to be a very clear choice to them, and they need to face that choice head on. I think it really is irresponsible for us to allow our troops. It's different when we didn't have that capability. We had troops there for many years, and the North Koreans were always a threat. We have troops all around the world that are at risk. But I think it's an unreasonable risk when we have the ability now to defend those troops. And that government, in cooperation with us, could defend those troops much more effectively. And I would welcome your comment on that.
So I think that that is something that what we saw was Moon was very cautious going into it. But he has actually made good strides towards us and away from North Korea on many levels. And, you know, those missiles that continue to be tested continue to push him the other way. I do think he was trying to slow walk THAAD to see where it was going to be. I also think he's getting pressure from China to get rid of THAAD. China is the number one country pushing them to get the THAAD system out. At the end of the day, I personally believe it's going to work itself out, but I also know that the administration, the second we see something that's not going in the favor of protection of our troops, then I know the president will act.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.